My next guest takes on Tony Martin at UFC 229 on October 6th. It is Ryan LaFlare joining me here on the program for the very first time. Ryan, how are you?
I'm great.
Awesome. How was training today? I imagine you just got back and all that?
Yeah, training's going great. You know, I'm just picking up. I'm a vet, even though I only got like 15 fights or 16 fights. I've been doing this stuff for like 11 years, so I'm starting really, I'm mastering the training camp thing, you know?
Yeah, getting used to it and all that. Do you have anything else later tonight, or is it taking the rest of the night off?
No, I sparred this morning. I went to PT afterwards, and now I'm taking the rest of the night off. I got my fantasy football draft.
Important stuff. I mean, you got to prioritize that, right? So
it's a big night.
Now, are you a guy that does like the rankings ahead of time so you know who to draft, or you just go in blindly and you're like, I'll take whoever the best is available?
No, I download an app and I just look to see, you know, and I follow I just follow the app's guidelines. I don't know. Not that good, but I find a way to make it to the championship every year. So,
are any other fighters in your league?
No. I played with Dennis Bermudez 1 year, and he got beginner's luck. I think he won the whole thing, but then he didn't want to do it again the next year.
Ah, I see. Okay.
My coach Keith Trimble, and that's it.
Let's talk about your last fight, man. You get that unanimous decision over Alex Garcia, and I know you would have probably liked the finish in that one, but you must have been pretty happy with your performance taking out a guy from TriStar.
Yeah, of course I'm happy. You know, a win is you're always happy with a win. You know, you could always got to improve, and you always want to improve on your last performance. Nothing's perfect, you know, your own worst critic. So, you know, there's things I want to work on. I want to be a little more active on the feet, throw more than one punch at a time, one kick at a time, and, you know, go back to my wrestling ways. I kind of veered away from my wrestling ways a little bit when I started getting, you know, just striking. So there's some things I want to work on, definitely.
And you find out you're on UFC 229, which of course is headlined by Khabib Nurmagomedov and Conor McGregor. I mean, how stoked were you when you found out you were on this card?
I mean, to be honest, I love to say, yeah, it's like a really big deal to me, but it really, I mean, every fight, you know, the octagon has 8 sides. I always say it doesn't matter where it is. You know, the only thing that matters is the person in front of you, you know, that you're fighting the same person, you know, no matter what the surroundings is. You know, if you're worried about that kind of stuff when you're fighting, you know, you got bigger problems to worry about. So I just, you know, care about Tony Martin that night. That's it. You know, I'll probably hang out, watch the rest of the fights, but it could be just me and him in someone's basement for all I care, you know?
Okay, fair enough. Now, it's always good to have the extra eyeballs on, though, for a big card like this. And you know, just speaking of this card, there's obviously a lot of fighters from your management group as well that are on here. I mentioned Khabib, and you work with Ali Abdelaziz. You know, how's that been having him as a manager? One of the things I hear that a lot of the fighters like is that he's not just asking about the fight stuff. He's asking about the family, the finances, and all that. How much of a benefit has that been in your career?
Yeah, I couldn't thank Ali enough. You know, I really consider him like family. You know, he's constantly called. I don't get that anxiety feel like every time your manager calls you, like, oh man, like what is he gonna say? You know, like I just feel, you know, he calls me all the time just you know, find out how the family is, how if I'm healthy and this, that, and other. So when he calls me, it's just like a regular phone call. And sometimes he's got fight news, sometimes he doesn't. It's kind of like, you know, it is. And, you know, and likewise, he 100% cares about his fighters as much as people, you know, want to say whatever they want to say. His fighters are legit his family. I've been to his house. His wife's made dinner for me. You know, he would do whatever he can for his guys.
Yeah, no, it's good to hear. And you never hear any of his fighters complain. You hardly see any of his fighters, you know, leave the group or whatever either. How long have you been working with him now?
You know, I was with Glenn Robinson before, and you know, and that kind of dwindled around. And I've known Ali since before I was in the UFC in 2012. Ali called me to fight in World Series of Fighting. I was actually at a contract with I was supposed to fight Josh Berkman in World Series of Fighting. Yeah. And then and he called me, and that's when I just signed with Glenn. And I booked the fight, and then I guess the UFC came in and was like, hey, we still have Ryan under contract, because I was under their Strikeforce banner, and I pulled out. So I've known Ali since 2012, but you know, we always, you know, we were very friendly when we saw her. And then, you know, when I was in between management, I reached out to him, and he was happy to jump up, you know, jump with me.
You mentioned your opponent here, Tony Martin, obviously looking good at welterweight. He's got that 13-4 record. How do you feel like you match up against him in this fight?
Yeah, I think it's a good fight. I think he's a very technical, good fighter. He's very similar to me. I think my wrestling, I'm a little bigger than him. I definitely have better wrestling than him. I think my striking is definitely better. He's sharp with striking. he's pretty sharp with his jiu-jitsu, but of course I think I match up better against him. You know, if I didn't think that, then I shouldn't be fighting, you know?
Right, exactly. Yeah, no, that's a good point. What about training camp? Is it just business as usual? Or are you doing anything different? Is it, you know, how are you sort of structuring your camp for this fight?
You know, back in, you know, when I first started, got into the UFC, and I first, you know, to me, it was like, I just had to train with the best guys around. You know, I didn't care. It was like, you know, the hardest part was the training camp and the fight was easy. But as I got older, I'll be 35 in a couple of weeks. You know, I really focus on myself. I you know, staying healthy, and, you know, I know how to fight. I've been doing it for 12 years and, you know, I've dedicated my life to it that long ago. And I've been dealing with a lot of injuries. I feel like I should have 30 fights, but, you know, I keep dealing with injuries. So I think I have to be smarter with my training camps. And, you know, choosing who I want to go with now, you know, I'm the old dog here. These young pups want to come in and they want to prove themselves against me. So I have to, be cautious with who I'm training with, you know?
Yeah, no, I hear you. What about training partners? Is it, you know, you mentioned Dennis Bermudez. I know you train a bit with Andre Harrison, Chris Wade. Who are some of the main guys that you kind of work with?
Yeah, well, I work at, you know, Belmore Kickboxing with Keith Trimble, and I work at Long Island MMA, my own gym in New York. So, you know, the only thing unfortunate is there's some really good 145 and 155ers in my neighborhood. And then after that, then it's the heavier guys.
Right, there's no, like, in between, yeah.
There's no really in between. It's just me, this guy Hugh McKenna and John Gotti Jr., well, the third. And, you know, I'm working with those guys. You know, I try to help them as much as possible. I'm kind of like a big brother mentor to them. Don't get me wrong, they're very, very tough guys. But and then I have, you know, Gian Vellante and Chris Weidman, who I, you know, I try to work with as much as possible. But again, you know, my competitive edge comes out, and I end up getting hurt when I go against the bigger guys. So I have to be smart, come down, you know, the last couple of weeks of my training camp.
And as you get older, I know the weight cut gets a little bit more tougher. How do you sort of do that as you're, you know, fighting against Father Time?
Well, I actually found it to be a little bit easier. It's a real profession for me. So I take it very seriously. So I don't just do my weight cut the week of the fight. So I start my diet maybe, you know, 7 to 8 weeks out, and I taper, you know, I get down to a certain number. And my weight cut for the past like three fights has been, you know, fairly easy. You know, obviously it sucks getting down, but I think that's my biggest advantage is, you know, the way that I can get down that weight and then recover and be able to perform, you know, at my maximum capacity.
Absolutely. Who's going to be in your corner for this fight?
Well, I work down south with Henry Hooft. I haven't been able to train with him as much as I would like to. You know, my kids are in school now. If you hear, they just walked in the door from the bus.
I do. Yeah, I know that time of year. Yeah.
So, you know, they just started school, so it's hard for me to get down there and train with Henry. But I stay in touch with him, and you know, we kind of game plan together, even though I don't see him as much as I used to. So I'm going to have Keith Trimble. I've been with Keith for, you know, about 11, 12 years, and he's always in my corner. And then my partner, my jiu-jitsu coach for Long Island MMA is Greg DePasquale. And then Henry's going to be cornering Nick Lentz. So he's going to be down there as well. So I'm going to have Henry in my corner, you know, too. And, you know, him and Keith have worked together before. So it's not like, oh, you have two striking coaches. You know, they understand. They know each other. You know, it's not an inconvenience.
And for you, it's the best of both worlds, having both of them there. So exactly. So it's a big benefit. So that's awesome. How do you see this fight playing out on October 6th?
Honestly, man, you know, everyone thinks that me and Tony are boring fighters. You know, I've heard it. You know, I'm on social media. People say what they want. I don't care, you know. I'm 7-2 in the UFC, and I'm sure his record's pretty similar. I think that I could finish him, but, you know, who knows? Everyone knows me as the decisionator. I just know that, you know, I'm going to bring it, and I know that I'm going to have my hands raised at the end of the fight, you know.
Obviously, people haven't picked up the accent. You are from New York. Are you a big New York sports fan? You watching any other sports outside of MMA?
I am a huge Giant fan. G-Man, I die. Always born and raised. You know, I was a season ticket holder a few years ago, and before I had my kids. And my father, you know, was a season ticket holder. And then I like the Yankees a lot, too. What's up, bud?
My son. Good stuff. Nice to meet him.
Yeah, he's a kindergartner.
What's his name?
He's Ryan, too. We call him RJ, though.
Okay, there you go. That's great. Yeah, sorry, you mentioned, you know, being a big sports fan and all that. How do you feel like the Giants are going to do this season? We got the NFL season right around the corner.
I'm always optimistic about the Giants. You know, if you're not optimistic about your team, then you're not a real fan. You know, you're a fair weather fan. So I think they're going to do great. I think, you know, I'm really excited for Barkley. See what he could do with the receiving corps. Even the offensive line, I think they made some big adjustments. You know, I wasn't crazy impressed with the preseason, but you know, that's normal. You know, it's preseason. That's why it's not the real game. You know, there's no game planning, no strategy. So we'll see how they do.
And last question before I let you go, because you did mention you're a Yankees fan. Do you and Chris Wade argue all the time? Because I know he's a Mets fan.
Yeah, I mean, it's kind of like, you know, it's a good team versus a bad team. You know, like there's no argument really. I feel bad for him. You know, we kind of keep it. You know, I stay out of it because I feel bad for him. I don't want to kill his hopes. You know.
Do you guys ever do any bets or anything when the two teams are playing?
No, because he's going to lose.
Okay, fair enough.
Feel bad for him, you know?
we'll just leave it at that. And, man, it was this is a great card coming up here. It's UFC 229. It's on October 6th. Ryan, it was great getting a chance to talk to you, man. I appreciate it, especially when you got your kids coming home. Just remind people where they can get a hold of you on social media. And if you have any sponsors or shout-outs, the floor is yours.
Right, yeah. You can find me on, I think, Instagram. I'm LaFlare MMA. My Twitter is RLaFlare. You know, I got hundreds of followers, so, you know, if I don't follow you back right away, it's hard to sift through all my tens of hundreds of followers. come follow me, man. I could use the support. Also, Gamma Labs, G Fuel, they definitely helped me out. I've been with them for years. Big sponsor. And Eat Clean, Bro, the best food on the Northeast Coast. If you want to check it out, check out at eatcleanbro.com. All the sponsors. Check out LongIslandMMA.com, LIMixedMartialArts.com. That's my gym. Come out there and train with the pros.
What's up, fight fans? If you like this video, be sure to subscribe to see even more interviews with your favorite UFC and Bellator fighters. We've also got coverage at events, including post-fight press conferences and media scrums. And if you like this video, check out the video to my right. It's worth your time.